Herzlich willkommen in Berlin-Friedrichshain.
Welcome to Berlin-Friedrichshain. I'm Jana Klee from Panorama-b, and I'm going to accompany you on this walk along Karl-Marx-Allee. Our tour takes you on a journey through time to a vanished country. We are now in former East Berlin, once the capital of the German Democratic Republic, or GDR for short. In no other part of Berlin can you trace back to the East German state with such intensity and variety. Here, history and architecture form a unity which represents the period from the founding of the GDR in 1949 to its collapse during the peaceful revolution of 1989. The Karl-Marx-Allee is one of the most important roads leading to the city centre from the east. Here, at Frankfurter Tor, you are welcomed by two magnificent dome towers. Behind them, enormous blocks of buildings with opulently decorated facades line the 90-metre-wide avenue for 2 kilometres towards Alexanderplatz. What some regarded as a masterly achievement of socialist architecture, others could only laugh at. During the Cold War, West German papers spoke of Stalinist gingerbread style, or the Via Triumphalis of the Russians, in order to belittle the prominent housing project. When it was started in 1952, the East German government aimed at campaigning for socialism and promising a better future for the people in the newly founded workers' and farmers' state. But often enough, a huge gap lay between the rulers' announcements and the standard of life in the GDR. This became strikingly obvious as early as 1953, during the uprising of the 17th of June. But more about that later. The history of this street goes back to the founding period of Berlin, around the year 1200. In the 19th century, when the Prussian capital Berlin became a booming industrial city, the neighbourhood along this old trading route changed from what had been a rural area to a densely clustered living and business quarter. This development accelerated after the foundation of the German Reich in 1871, as from then on Berlin was the capital of Germany as a whole. In search of a living, many people moved from the countryside to the city, and soon the million-strong metropolis was afflicted by a massive housing shortage. The working-class quarters in the north and the east of Berlin, like the surrounding Friedrichshain borough, became notorious for their disastrous living conditions. In tenement houses, large families were crammed into tiny spaces. Many flats looked out onto gloomy and airless backyards and were exposed to industrial dirt and noise. As well as hunger and poverty, disease was rife, caused by damp and mouldy rooms and a lack of fresh air, sun and hygiene. With up to 1,500 inhabitants per hectare, Friedrichshain was one of the most densely populated parts of Berlin, and one of the poorest, too. In the last days of the Second World War, in April 1945, this road marked one of the main routes on which the Soviet army made its way towards the city centre. Despite the hopeless situation, Adolf Hitler had given orders to continue fighting until the very end, and so the Battle of Berlin was fought fiercely up to the German surrender on the 2nd of May 1945. The artillery and house-to-house combats left the area devastated. About 70% of the buildings along the street were destroyed, and so the Berlin city government agreed to concentrate rebuilding efforts on this part of Friedrichshain. Construction work started in 1949. Ready for more discoveries in Berlin? The Panorama-b app combines multimedia walking tours with a classic city guide, giving you an exciting and informative way to explore the city offline. Just download it now.